Hey guys, welcome to BitBoy Crypto. I am your host, BitBoy. If you're not a member of our community, make sure that you do that. Click the subscribe button to become a member of the Bit Squad. If you do, you get to enter all of our contests. Our actual last contest ended last night with our HODL trade or dump video. I'll be doing a live stream tomorrow night where we will pick the winner and announce the next contest. So if you are a member of the Bit Squad, you also get to follow me along with my awesome journey I'm on in crypto. If you guys don't know, I've actually been in LA shooting a pilot for a TV show. Yes, I'm able to reveal a few more details, still not able to give the name of the show yet, but I'm going to put some pictures on the screen and you guys can see it looked like a really fun day. It was really fun for me. I didn't know how much work it is to do a TV show, but now I know. I'm from the country. I'm from Georgia. I've never been in it. Well, I've been to LA, but I've never been here for something film or TV production oriented. So it's very interesting for me to kind of get a behind the scenes look. And they call me the talent. I like that. So if you are, I guess, if you're on camera, you're called the talent. I thought that was so funny. I think I'm going to make my wife, Mama Wild Things, start calling me the talent. So you guys let me know if you guys think that that would be a good idea and that she should do that. So, but it was really awesome. Yes, it is in a bunker. There is like a bunker kind of reference to my show. So I can't wait for you guys to see it when it comes out. And World CryptoCon, they will be releasing what they call a sizzle, which will be a little bit of my show and a little bit of, some of my other friends and Satoshi Dropper shows. And you guys will get to see what CryptoCake TV is trying to do. Hopefully, if everything goes well, launching in February and going forward with the show and things like that, might be moving out here to LA. Just not really 100% sure about anything at this point, but I do know it was really super fun to come to LA and film this. And, we'll just have to see what happens from here. So, okay, guys, let's jump into the markets. Right now, the markets are not doing too great. They're at $219 billion. We're down a little bit today. People were anticipating in anticipation of Ripple's conference this week, the Swell conference, that the price would go up. But right now, the price is not doing so swell. it is down about 8.5%, Ripple is, or XRP. I don't know if that will continue. I think it will probably pump back up, but that's just a guess. I'm not a financial advisor. Bitcoin is around $6,500, about $6,557. Like I said, it is down a little bit. We had a little bit of a Bart Simpson earlier in the week, but now, things have kind of stabilized back around the 65 to 66 level. We just keep testing 67. We just can't really get over and stay over it. So, okay, let's look at the news today. ICO in China is still on. Nobody gives a damn about the ban. That's the title of the article. Here's the thing. We see this all the time with different countries. We see it with China. We see it with India, where I think if you don't live there or you don't know people who are there, you would think that they're just not buying crypto. Well, that's absolutely not true. It is kind of easy to get around in those countries, these ICO bans, and invest. It's also easy to buy crypto through different kinds of exchanges. Payfair, for instance, is one where it doesn't matter where you live. You can use it. There's no KYC requirements. So because of websites like that, people are still able to invest in crypto. And I personally know someone who lives in India who says that, all this is overblown and that they're actually buying crypto up in India. People are very interested. But of course, the government doesn't support it. So actually here in the United States, the government's been a little more friendly towards crypto. So we'll just have to see how all this kind of stabilizes around the world. So we're starting to get a lot more articles about people predicting the next bull run. Which is crazy because it seems like that's all we've talked about for 9 months. But now the charts are possibly suggesting that this is true as well. And this is the word of warning I would like to give everyone. While I would like to come on here and say, yes, we're definitely going up. Go get your crypto. The truth is, just as easily as we could have another move up, we could also have another move down, which I don't think is going to happen. I certainly hope that we're going to have this move up. All I'm saying is I would not take a second mortgage out on your house at this point. If you haven't already done it. Now, if you've already done it because you felt like that was the bottom, then certainly I wish you a lot of luck. And hopefully we'll see the price move up. But like I said, I think you just got to be careful with articles like this, because what will happen is if everyone's anticipating a bull run and we move down, that will make the move down much worse. So, but there are some TA experts that are starting to predict, like here, this one says a Bitcoin breakaway. Technical indicators show Bitcoin's price could be going up. I don't know a lot about TA, so I can't really comment on the specific charts of it, but just something I want to share with you guys. So here we got Stellar Base Zero Fee Decentralized Crypto Exchange. Stellar X is now fully launched. We reported on this back in July in anticipation of this, and now here it is. They have released it. Let's take a quick look at it. This is Stellar X. Interesting thing about this website here, it doesn't go up and down. If you see my mouse moving up and down, it goes left to right. So there's not too much to the front end of the website. I haven't actually signed up for it yet. I will be doing a Stellar X review and show you guys what it's like to sign up for it. I guess it's functional. It says it's fully functional, but I won't 100% know until I sign up and get on it. So I'll be doing that this week, so you guys be on the lookout for that. All right, and last story, we've got Volkswagen Group confirmed they will put blockchains on the road. Just more adoption news, more mainstream news. Volkswagen, if you didn't know, is already working on a secret concept project with IOTA. They are partners at this point. And so now Volkswagen is coming out and saying, like, yes, we are going to put blockchains on the road. So if you guys don't think blockchain technology is taking over, you really need to get your head out of the sand and look around at everything that is happening. You've got this huge car company saying that they're putting blockchains on the road. And who knows, maybe the blockchains will be able to assist, you know, with the self-driving cars and things like that. Let me rephrase that. I'm sure that it will, but maybe it'll help kind of solve some of the problems that they're having at this point, why that hasn't, why there aren't more of those on the road. I really like the idea of being able to ride around in my car wherever I want to go and just being on Twitter. That's what I like. Or, you know, doing research or you know, whatever it might be without having to worry about the distraction of texting and driving. And, you know, we just got to face it, guys. Texting and driving is such a bad problem. And, of course, I'm certainly guilty of it myself. But, you know, it's such a problem in our country, and it's only going to continue to get worse. So maybe the self-driving cars will be the help that we need. But, of course, they got to stop running over people. So, okay, guys, that's all I got. Heading back to Atlanta here in a few hours, and tomorrow I'll be back on schedule with a few videos for you guys. Thank you for all the support. If it wasn't for you guys, like I said in the last video or a couple nights ago maybe, I wouldn't be here. I would not be here in LA without my subscribers, without the Bit Squad, without everybody that follows me on Twitter and Instagram. So once again, just big thank you to you guys. That's not me puffing smoke. That is literally, I thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. So, all right, guys, thanks a lot. BitBoy out.